kingdom high upon a hill in a land of long ago. Sat a woeful king waiting for the sting of death's impending blow. For a clockwork dragon to the west burned a village all away. Breathing fire and steam, it had now been seen heading in the kingdom's way. Protective of his subjects, this king issued a decree. He stood before his kingdom and cried, "This is what we need. Ring the banner, who will fight the dragon to the death? Warriors to go extinguish fierce and fiery breath. Selfless knights to fight in battle, man against machine. Heroes who will give their lives for king and queen." The dragon got the king's best men, they were no match for the beast. To the fire they'd run, and yet one by one, every knight wound up deceased. Now a wee young girl named Valerie, with an artificial heart, to the king did speak, and though small and meek, she was kind and she was smart. She asked the king, "Why don't we try approaching peacefully?" The king, he laughed and said, "Dear girl, I'll tell you what we need. Bring a banner, who will fight the dragon to the death? Warriors to go extinguish fierce and fiery breath. Selfless knights to fight in battle, man against machine. Heroes who will give their lives for king and queen." But Valerie was strong of heart, and she knew what she must do. Her clockwork heart was guiding her, and she had to follow through. And so she traveled to the fields, and she called the dragon near. As it flew on down, it could hear a sound quite familiar to its ears. The ticking of her clockwork heart sounded so much like its own, and the calming tick had reminded it of its maker way back home. The dragon bowed to Valerie to willingly concede. The humbled king then proudly shouted, "She's the one we need. We need Valerie to tame the dragon for us all. Who'd have ever thought our hero would have been so small? She has soothed the sound.